What the Democrats need to do is use their power properly. Their power is to investigate what's investigatable. And what the first thing that they're going to have to investigate is that the President of the United States fired the FBI because they were going to do a Russian investigation, and that's why this Mueller investigation is taking place. Now, he just fired Jeff Sessions, his own hand-picked attorney general. His own hand-picked attorney general.
And Frank, now just bear with me 1 second. Jeff Sessions is one of the most popular people in Washington, I would think. He's a lovable guy, an honest man. He made one mistake. If he was going to recuse himself, which he did, he should have told the president. He didn't.
He did tell the president. He recused himself
after he...
only after he lied on behalf of the president. He lied to defend the president. Listen to me. I said it today in a tweet that made everybody go nuts. Donald Trump could not park Jeff Sessions' car. Jeff Sessions is a consummate, intelligent, intellectual lawyer. He's been a district attorney. This guy is extremely well respected. Trump destroyed him, berated him, cut him up, pushed him in a corner, and finally told him to fucking resign.
Yeah, well, I don't, you know, Frank, I agree with you. What you say is true. There's only one difference. One is a president. The other is nothing now.
Right.
And that's life in the fast lane, Frank.
Yeah, 100%. You're 100%
along
correct.
The way.
When a CEO fires you, you got two things you can do. Either shut the fuck up and move on and try not to create ripples, and maybe you'll get a letter of recommendation for your next fucking gig, if there is one, right?
Right.
Or you get a lawyer and sue them.
Yep.
There's no in between. Now, Jeff Sessions, I watched the emotional goodbye. He was crying.
I'm sure he would be. I'm sure he would be.
And I think that this fucking president
is a shameful
piece of shit.
A job of a
lifetime.
Exactly.
This president is not worthy of the presidency. This president is not worthy of the United States of America, one of the greatest countries in the world, which I love and I respect, and I thank God every day that they're the neighbors of our small little country.